क्लास 195 मींस 65 इलेक्ट्रिकल एक्चुएटर्स और इलेक्ट्रिकल एक्चुएटर सिस्टम्स। सो इट इज ए सिस्टम वेयर इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी इज यूज्ड फॉर मोशन। सो यू हैव देयर मेनली स्विचिंग डिवाइसेस एंड रियल एक्चुएटर्स दैट इज ड्राइव्स। ओके सो स्विचिंग डिवाइसेस वी हैव मैकेनिकल स्विचेस एंड सॉलिड स्टेट स्विचेस और सेमी कंडक्टर स्विचेस। मैकेनिकल स्विचेस कैन बी कीबोर्ड, लिमिट स्विच इन फोटो कॉपियर्स मशीन्स यू हैव लिमिट स्विच। When you move over a particular position, when you reach the limit at the end of the paper or the page or the document, you have limit switch. Even in drawers, you have limit switch. You can have. When you open the drawer fully, a switch will be activated. Or close it fully, a switch will be activated. Sometimes used for interlocks also. Float switches, say in fluid level sensors, you can have float switches. Okay, float sensor actuates a switch. Similarly, pressure switch, temperature switch, say thermostat, it is a temperature switch. Push button switch, SPST, all these things. So these are mechanical switches. Some switches are mechanical switches only, but operated electromagnetically. Examples are relays and solenoids. And then solid state switches. We have diodes, transistors, and thyristors. Okay, next, drive system. You have DC motors, AC motors, and other special motors like stepper motors, universal motors, etc. Now, a short note on mechanical switches. Not sure how much you have to study for your syllabus. Here these things are given. If you want, you can study. It is self-explanatory. Bouncing and debouncing. It means actually a small arcing that takes place when a switch is actuated from off state to on state. This is not at all said in your syllabus. You might have studied this in your other subject, digital electronics. So just a short explanation here. So when you go from, when you switch on a switch or switch off it, while oning and off, okay, it while going, it does not go directly to on state. It goes to on state, again disconnects some for a short period, may not be this much, only some milliseconds, okay. There will be small arcing taking place in the contact. This is called as bouncing. Okay, neither high nor low. Like a ball you bounce. It is neither in the air, neither in the top in your hand or not in the bottom on the floor. It is in the air. Okay, so there is also a circuit like what is to prevent this bouncing, you have debouncing circuit. Which can be hardware or software. Hardware means you can have using flip-flop or split trigger. By software also you have. You might have studied this. Or okay, don't worry. You need not study that. Next we have solenoids. Solenoids is nothing but a coil and movable armature. You know that. There are two types. One is the armature, okay, or piston or plunger, okay. Armature is called as plunger when it has this type of shape, piston type of shape. When that is inside the coil, we call this as plunger type solenoid. The coil has plunger inside, and there is a spring. Due to spring action, the solenoid will be outside. When current flows through the coil, the armature or plunger will be attracted. When current is removed, plunger will go to the its previous position. You can have tension in the spring or contraction as you like. So it can move upward or downward as you like. In non-plunger type, the coil is on a stationary core. In plunger, the core itself is moving. Core itself is the plunger armature. The stationary core is used only to increase the flux density. This has no work here. But if you place this, the leakage flux will become lesser. You get better magnetic characteristics. Here, coil is kept on the stationary core, and there is spring here which will keep armature away. When coil is energized, the armature will be attracted towards the core, because core has become no magnet, electromagnet, and armature is a magnetic material, either here or here. So this is how operation takes place. Relay, you know, we have NO type and NC type. Okay, I think there is no need to explain these things. Simple relay is given here. Single pole, double throw. Only one pole, single pole is given. Double throw because it transfers from NO to NC, NC to NO. So it has two contacts, or one set of NO and NC contacts. Hence it is a SBTT relay. Now, I think this is simple, you know that. Solid state switches. You can have diode. Diode is not actually switcher, but it acts as switcher. Sometimes when you suppose say you want to use it as a freewheel diode, switch on or switch off, say reverse bias, forward biased. So it acts as a switch to some extent. And next you have transistors, power MOSFETs, SCR, track, GTO, etc. So these all things you know, you have studied in power electronics in previous class, previous semester. One by one explanation is given here. Not sure whether this is required for examination. I think this much would be enough, 400. But if they ask how an SCR can be operated as switch, you will have to write this. Also try to memorize the symbol of each and everything.